Bradshaw's notes the tin and copper mines being worked in his day. But as that industry has been largely worked out, I'm interested in a Cornish element that's on the rise.
Bradshaw's quotes what it claims is a well-known rhyme. By tree, pollen, pen, you may know Cornish men. And then it gives examples from place names, Tregothnan, Polperro, Penryn. And it strikes me that now I'm in Cornwall, I should learn a few words of Cornish.
The Cornish language was in decline for centuries. It's undergone a revival in recent decades, and now around 2,000 people are said to be fluent. Matthew Clarke, Jerry Jeffries, and Loveday Jenkin meet up regularly to keep their language alive.
I hear you all speaking Cornish. How unusual does that make you these days?
Not as unusual as it used to be.
Is that right?
Yeah. The language is expanding quite a lot.
Would it be an exaggeration to say that it was once a dead language?
Well, it's quite interesting to think about that, because actually, although it wasn't used as a means of communication for maybe about 70, 80 years, it's never really died out, the knowledge of Cornish. It's just as a spoken language.
How closely related is it to other Celtic languages?
The strongest link, I suppose, is between Cornish and Breton.
And in fact, up to the 1500s, it was mutually intelligible, Cornish and Breton, at that time.
The three prefixes that people might know nothing of Cornish, tre, poll and pen, what do they actually mean?
Tre, which is like a hamlet or a homestead, and then you get the poll, which is a pool, and the pen, which is a headland or a hill. And you find those in Brittany as well, and all across the map in Wales as well. That really makes a strong distinction of Celtic territory.
So how do I say hello?
Divda.
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 Divda. How do I say thank you?
Merasis.
Merasis. Merasis. How do I say please?
Ma
pleg. Ma pleg. And how do you say cheers?
Yehesda.
Yehesda.
Yehesda, indeed. Yehesda.